honored this week to be doing the Trump and Hillary cabinets for the Boston Globe. We start with Trump. He's kind of a squatty circle or a boxy shape with the hair coming about halfway down, covering his eyes. In my case, this week, we see the eyes. And here's my method. Quite often if I'm not using pen and ink, do the whole thing in a very light graphite, cover it with some watercolor, and then add more tone or watercolor until I achieve a tone, a density, and modeling that I like. Here's the first step is to add some water, and then light tones, more graphite, and then finally we get the Trump that I want. Kind of a smug fellow. His vice president is Hulk Hogan, of course. And then moving to Director of Homeland Security, Ted Nugent, Secretary of Education. Who else? The Divine Sarah. For the head of the EPA, it might be Willie Robertson. He says, "I love Trump. How could you not love Trump?" Then for Secretary of Defense, we have the one and only Bobby Knight, who says, "Here's a man who would do the same thing, drop the atomic bomb, because he's going to become one of the four great presidents of the United States." That all makes sense if you think about it. Then Dennis Rodman, I think a perfect choice for Secretary of State. He says, "We don't need another politician. We need a businessman like Mr. Trump. And what we do need is a man of Mr. Rodman's level of international understanding, particularly with respect to North Korea, with which he has shown tremendous deft expertise." And here we have the entire group gathered together for a cabinet shot. Smile, everybody. For the Hillary Clinton cabinet, I think her vice presidential candidate might be Beyoncé, young lady of great talent and a great resume, a Hillary supporter, and someone with a bit of panache. Amy Schumer for Health and Human Services, someone very connected to her health and also her human services. Now, if you were picking a Secretary of Defense, who would you rather have than Rosie O'Donnell? She says, "If Hillary Clinton were a man, there would be no question she was the most qualified." And for Attorney General, we'd have Snoop Dogg, who said, "I would love to see a woman in the office." Yes, another ringing endorsement for a woman. Lena Dunham, Secretary of the Interior, adds to the trend by saying, "Hillary has survived horrific gendered attacks." Warren Buffett, perhaps a surprise choice of Secretary of Labor, says, "We must make sure that people who have to work two jobs to barely get by will not have that kind of world going forward." Perhaps the biggest star on the stage would be the inimitable Kim Kardashian, who endorsed Hillary on Twitter by saying, "I've got my selfie." Perhaps Secretary of Education. And so, here's the group cabinet portrait of the Hillary gang. While their endorsements may not be too heavy on the personal, as Hillary might say, they are at least all together. And that much seems to be clear. Thank you.